I'm Griffin, and I can't talk in this thing. Hold on. Alright, that's much better. Now, there.
Hello, I'm Jordan, and you're not.
And this is my review on...
Hold on, let me scoot over here so you can see me. Friday the 13th, Part 6. Jason Lives. Now, 2 years ago, I reviewed Friday the 13th, Part 5, A New Beginning. So, Jason Lives is actually probably, without a doubt, my favorite of the entire Friday the 13th franchise. Part 5, A New Beginning... is basically like the ninth season of Dallas. You just pretend that it never happened. So, Part 6 is the new Part 5, so it should be Friday the 13th, Part 5, Jason Lives. Yeah. Alright. There's a few things that I love about Jason Lives. One thing, it's gothic. Like, the first 5 minutes of the whole movie, it's like a gothic, you know, foggy cemetery. And there's Alice Cooper music, and there's car chases, and there's actors' dark comedy, and what else? And just little tributes to other, you know, horror fans and horror directors like John Carpenter. They mentioned like Carpenter Road and Boris Karloff, who played Frankenstein in the old school Frankenstein movie. Just tiny little things like that I love. All right, so. Tommy Jarvis, who's not played by Corey Feldman, thank goodness. Yeah, I don't really like Part 5, the final chapter, that well. Everyone always raves about how the final chapter is so great, but it's just okay. It's overrated. Yeah, there, I said it. Final chapter's overrated. Suck it. Alright, so we start off with Tommy Jarvis, who... gets out of the asylum. He doesn't break out because Part 5 didn't happen. Yeah, they don't even mention Part 5 at all, which is a good thing. So, Tommy and his friend him and his friend go to the cemetery to dig up Jason just to see if he's alive or dead. And so, Tommy gets this, like a poker from the fence and stabs Jason with it. And then he's going to, like, incinerate him. But a lightning strikes and it zaps right through him, which looks like a lightsaber. And that magically brings Jason back to life. Tommy was so stupid to do that. I mean, he saw that Jason was dead in his grave. Why couldn't he just see him laying there and get on with his life? Instead of bringing him back and then having him come back for 7, 8, 9, and 10. Darn you, Tommy Jarvis. Alright, so whenever Jason comes back, Tommy goes to the sheriff's office, Sheriff Garris, and tells him that Jason is alive and he's coming back to Camp Crystal Lake. But they renamed it to Camp Forest Green because they want people want to forget that it was Camp Crystal Lake. I guess kind of like in Freddy vs. Jason, that people want to forget that Freddy Krueger actually lived there, and they covered it up to, you know, show that Freddy never lived there. It was a cover-up! It was a conspiracy! Oh, sorry. Silly conspiracy theorists. Alright, so Tommy automatically falls in love with the sheriff's daughter, Megan. And Megan happens to work at Camp Forest Green. She's a... one of the counselors there, along with her other friends like Court and Sissy and other random person and girl. So the whole time, Tommy is trying to convince Sheriff Garris that Jason is alive and back. So while he's doing this, Jason is out killing people that are playing paintball gun, shooting paintballs at each other in his territory. So they're supposed to be like company executives. They're serious businessmen who take their paintball very serious. And there's one scene that, you know, Jason gets his machete by this guy who thinks that women should stay in the kitchen. You know, he takes it from his hand, he rips it off, and the guy's arm is still attached to the machete, and his face hits a tree, and there's like a smiley face, and it's like a bloody smiley face, which is, you know, dark humor. You know, it's funny. And Jason looks at the arm on the machete, he's like, like that. And that's when Jason gets closer to going back to Forest Green, which is supposed to be Camp Crystal Lake. Wow, my neck's hurting. So, later that night, this movie does take place on Friday the 13th. Like, parts 3, 4, and... Yeah, all, like, 3 and 4 are, like, probably within a few days of each other. Like, Sunday the 15th or something. And then, you know, Megan helps Tommy break out of the jail. And there's, like, an awesome car chase scene played by... They play, like, some music over, and it's, like, really awesome and hardcore and shit. And Tommy gets the idea that he's going to take Jason back to his original resting place in the bottom of Crystal Lake. So he's going to get this big old boulder, and he's got all this chains. He's going to chain Jason to the bottom of the lake. And there's, like, you know, there's kids there this time. There's actually kids there sleeping or, you know, like, camping there at Camp Forest Green. It's supposed to be Crystal Lake. And you know, the kids are funny, actually. There's, you know, when, you know, Jason's out there killing people, and you hear Megan screaming, "Daddy! Ah!" And the kids are like, "So, what were you going to be when you grew up?" And there's a little girl named Nancy. She's the one that actually sees Jason out and about, but the grown-ups, you know, the counselors don't believe her, because little kids don't know anything. And, you know, she's kind of like Tommy Doyle in the original Halloween. No, like, she sees Jason like how Tommy saw, you know, Michael, but no one believes her. And so Tommy Jarvis, not Tommy Doyle, Tommy and Megan, you know, team up to go back to Camp Crystal Lake and try to stop, you know, Jason. But the police are out there. You know, there's like a big old, the whole police team is out there trying to stop Jason, but he kills them all left and right because Jason's badass. So it's up to Tommy to stop Jason once and for all. Or is it Megan that helps, that does that? So, yeah, this is definitely one of my favorites of the whole series. It's much more different than just, you know, teenagers going to a random, you know, cabin in the woods, and Jason just happens to show up and just kills them all left and right. You know, it's a different storyline, and I give this an A+. So maybe every now and then I'll probably come back and, you know, review all the other Friday the 13th. Like, I probably won't review 1 or 2 or 3 or 4 anytime soon. Actually, I prefer the later sequels, like 6, 7, and 8, and 10. I don't like Jason Goes to Hell? I guess I can review that then. Alright, I hope you like my review, and I hope you give me a like, thumbs up, and I hope you're getting ready for Halloween.